Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about Power BI release November 2023. There are a lot of features Power BI team has released as part of this November 2023. But I'm going to discuss about the few features that I am mostly interested in. Let's try to jump into the video right away. So what are the features I like? In reporting, I like the button slicer, the new button slicer and reference labels. But button slicers are so familiar with the custom visuals, but now Power BI has added that as a default visual. And the reference labels is something we can enhance our card visuals, that is especially a new card visual. And you can customize the new card visuals with some other measures, some icons and some greater than, increase or decrease symbols, those things. So these two features, it's really good. I will quickly show a demo while I'm completing this presentation. Then comes modeling. In modeling, right now some people might be confused, because if you have seen the services, it is renamed as semantic models. This is for your information. So going forward, we will not call the data sets, it will be renamed to semantic models. So don't confuse while you see in the services, instead of data sets you will see only the semantic models. I think it will take some time for us to digest or register in our mind. So we will repeat semantic models 10 times so that we will have that name registered. And we have a DAX query view to write and run. So in the Power BI modeling, you have something like you can have your DAX query view. Usually in order to write and to do the trial and error method, we usually go for some external tools. So Power BI bringing all these features in the Power BI itself, that is a great feature. And when you move on to services, I like this edit your data model in Power BI services. If you are not aware, edit your data model in Power BI services, it was released around April or May 2023. So we can directly edit our models in the Power BI services. This will be a really good feature. When you have large models, you no need to deploy from your production and takes long time, but you need to fix it immediately, adding some measures or creating some relationship. This feature will be a very useful thing. And right now they have enhanced some of the feature that may not be possible, that is not possible earlier release, like creating a table as a date table and adding removing tables or columns. That is not possible till November 2023. Now from this release, you can able to add, edit a column or table in Power BI service itself, and also you can set the table as a date table. Then this is the one of the exciting feature I liked, that is explore option. So basically, once you publish your data set reports in the Power BI services, mostly the read users, someone who is not supposed to touch the report, because people sometimes they want to explore certain things, they edit the reports, existing production reports or whatever report that end users are using. So they mistakenly save the current report, so with the draft versions, that will create confusion. So instead of that, people can explore from the data model. They can test whatever they want to create their exploration, and they can share as well. So this is the another important feature I liked. There are lots of features released as part of this November 2023. If you want to explore all of this, you can do so. Right now, I quickly show some of the features that I like from this list. One last thing, this channel contains a free content that covers Power BI, SQL, data warehouse, and it also talks about SSIS and SSAs. So please share this free content with your friends and colleagues. Let's jump into demo. So I'm in Power BI desktop now with November 2023. So one thing related to the buttons, right? So that is a slicer button added newly. You can see this is the conventional button. Right now you have a slicer new. This is the slicer button. So just you can add it and play around with that. So I'm not going to showcase completely. So this is the slicer button. Then there comes the data labels, right? Reference labels I'm talking about. You can see this is the card visual. That is new card visual. And you can have reference labels. You can add as many as labels over here, and you can able to customize add icons and symbols all other together. So this is about the reference label. These are the future small things that will enhance your reports to the next level. I hope this is a very good future. Then other thing I'm talking about is the DAX query view. You can try out your DAX over here. So just you have your measures here, you can write your measures and then you can try it out. So this is the another super feature you can try out, and once it works, then you can create this measure in your model. That is one of the beautiful feature. I hope this is already you are aware. This is not part of this release, but I never talked about it. I mean, I talked about previous release. I didn't show the demo. So this is for everyone information. Like, we have a semantic model. That is why they renamed as a semantic model, where you can see the whatever objects in your data sets. Like, it can contain the calculation group. So till now, before April or May or June, before introducing this model view, we only know measures and relationship. That's it, right? So we are not sure about what is calculation group cultures. I mean, those who we can able to create using the another external tools. Right now you can able to see certain features in this Power BI. Some features you still need to go to the external tools and create it. So this is about the semantic model. So whatever the internal objects or excess objects you are going to create as part of the model, which will be available in the model tab. I will have a detailed video soon about all other things over here. And another thing is like, let's go over here. So out of six things I liked, so I explained about this card reference, and I'm going to show you the explore option. Let's go from the top. So there you go, explore. So this is what I'm talking about. So once you publish your report in your Power BI services in the semantic model, okay, it's not a data set anymore, it's a semantic model. So once you click on the semantic model, right click, explore this data, which is in the preview model, and you can try it out. Like, you can get a list of things over here. You can drag and drop and you can play around with your data. It can show the data in the tabular and the visual view. You can split the screens either horizontally or vertically. So basically this is to explore your data. You are not disturbing the existing data set or the reports, so you are exploring on your own. So once you are okay, you can save this as your exploration. That will be saved as a new type over here. You can see the different types here, report, semantic model, and there will be another type created, exploration. You can share that exploration with other people. Is this correct, or is my finding is correct? Can we include this exploration in the new report, this report, instead of directly editing in the report? This will be very nice feature, and it can be extended for testing purposes as well. I mean, usually testers use the reports currently. They can use this feature for their own testing purpose. So I'm not talking anything about Copilot or Fabric yet, because I'm not so familiar with those topics. So once I'm familiar and I practiced it, I will definitely create video on the Fabric series. I hope you like this video. If you like it, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.